a challenge to you, Hans, and the Minister of Foreign Affairs, since the forest thing has been moved to the Minister of Environment. Please don't forget that natural resources is the basis for poor people, and that that should be a part of the basis in your development policies and political policies. What's the greeting? Thank you. Next person is Jonas Gahr Støre. He is a former Minister of Foreign Affairs. He's now an MP, and recently was elected as a chair of the Labour Party, the biggest party in Norway. And because of that, I think he's a person who most people in Norway want to know, what does he really mean? The word is yours.
Well, that's a long story, Dag, what I really mean. I will not bore you with that today, but I would like to join those who congratulate the Rainforest Foundation, which really, I think, is a truly extraordinary creation. And let me, this room is so full of experience on rainforests and how important it is to climate change. We are convinced that it matters to poverty reduction and development. That I will not repeat that. We have a notion in Norway saying that repeating something that everybody knows is like carrying coal to Newcastle. That's what the Americans do these days. They carry coal from the US to Europe. This is a bad idea, by the way. But I would like to make two or three reflections upon what I've heard, and it's good also to see the minister with her dedication, and also Hans, who I have worked with in the past and have great admiration for his dedication to these topics. I mean, first of all, as a social democrat, we see, as Francis said, climate change as regressive. And we want to be progressive. So it inspires our approach to this with an action-oriented philosophy. When I would like to congratulate the Rainforest Foundation, it's for three specific reasons. And let me be brief so you don't feel outflattered, Dag. One is that you are a true civil society organization, which the more I see traveling around the world, how important it is to democracy, to stability, and to national identity. Yesterday I heard Paul Collier here in Oslo talking about disintegrating identities because there is no structure in societies, as we see so many worrisome signs around the world. But you play an important role there. But what really adds value is that you also combine this with knowledge and creativity. So I think whoever sits in the ministries and in the governments in Norway will turn to you also for insight, not only listening to you in the streets and at conferences with your slogans, and you should carry them, but also we need to listen to you when it comes to every insight you have and how that can inspire our work. And I know, for one, that that is true. Our rainforest initiative that came out in the government that I served, and at that time Hans worked with me and not on the other side, but I think we agree on most of these issues. We turn to you for inspiration. To break a cycle which was out there in the international environment where countries with no interest in forest and basically not much interest in development and with no interest in coming up with money, stopped negotiations on forests, blocked them. So we had to find another way of working, creating a coalition for action of countries, indigenous people, civil society around the world who really saw the urgency. And then come up with something that could work. And I would like to salute rainforest activists for being breaking new ground in development thinking in the last decade. And I think you are then at the level with an area that I know better, which is public health, global public health. I believe in the health field and in the rainforest field, we have seen the most spectacular innovation in the way we have worked to promote change. Now, you have expertise in rainforest, and I think, Jane, I read your article where you have, Francis, when you had made your points about food security, energy security, human health, human safety, indigenous people. I mean, it's very well argued. My business here is how do we make change happen? How do we create politics and how do we engineer change at the international level? which is becoming increasingly complicated because this world is becoming zero polar. It is no longer able to take real global decisions, which is very worrisome. But in health and in rainforests, there has been very significant progress. And I really hope that you will continue to move forward and take risks, because it is risky. Now, in both areas, in vaccines and in rainforest preservation, we have paid for performance, which was very controversial. It's a very old technology, paying people to not to do something. And then normally you would reach a result. But it is controversial from ethical and other angles. But in health, we have been able to spread vaccines and efforts for maternal health and child health in a way that we could not assume possible in the past, by paying for performance. And I think the same principle inspired the Prime Minister I worked with, Erik Solheim, who I worked with, Hans and his teams, when we set up the partnerships with Brazil and with Indonesia. And I know, for one, having worked closely with Indonesia, how many risks you were taking, friends from Indonesia, in setting up institutions, dealing with corruptions, and securing the transparency and accountability that we needed to put millions of Norwegian taxpayers' money into this. But it has worked, it has been evaluated, and on balance, it is not without flaws. There are still needs that need to be covered. But it hadn't been serious if it had been all perfect, because it is work in progress. So I think that we have been through a game changer in forest protection. And I really urge you to continue your work, all of you who are from this huge range of angles, to continue to push knowledge, and insights. And I'd like to end with one point that you had in this article, Francis, that I read, which was about triple wins, which I think is crucial for the next argument of convincing people of the need to engage. And that is to illustrate that all these issues on development, poverty reduction, and climate change are linked. I think we here all see that. But we need to bring that argument to decision makers who don't deal with it on an everyday basis. In WHO, when I worked there, we used to say that health ministers, they know. The ones we need to convince are prime ministers, presidents, and finance ministers. They too are health ministers. And they too have to become rainforest ministers. And I happen to serve in a government where the Minister of Finance and Prime Minister indeed were rainforest-minded in their thinking, and they were health-minded in the way they were thinking. Partly because they were progressive, I would say, and partly because the arguments were driven through and driven home, and you could see the links. And it is necessary to illustrate the economics of action and why it really matters to engage. So, all credibility and cred, as we say in Norwegian, to the Rainforest Foundation for all of you who come together. Congratulations on this fine day, and I can assure you that at some moment in time, we will be back in force to be progressive on this issue again. Thank you.